C4 and Bryan Nehman.
WBAL News Radio 1090, FM 101.5, and the WBAL radio app.
Well, it's going to be a big shakeup in Maryland politics this year, in Washington at least, where Senator Ben Cardin is not going to be around. He's decided not to run for re-election. John Sarbanes, and now Dutch Ruppersberger last week
David
announced
Trone.
That he is not running. David Trone is running for Senate, so his congressional seat is up. So it is going to definitely be a different looking delegation next year. Coming up in 2024 November, but these jobs don't come around very often.
No,
so when they do, you know, it's always kind of interesting to see who wants
to get
in.
Got to go
for it. I mean, not going to get in. Our next guest is going to make the trek, where he's going to try to make the trek to Washington now. Johnny Olszewski, the Baltimore County Executive, who has announced that he is in fact running for Congress in that second congressional seat. Great to have you on.
Good
as
morning,
always.
County
Appreciate
exec.
Coming on the show.
Guys, always great being on with you. Thanks for having me.
All right, so let's get into it. You know, we think we understand why, but you tell us why you've decided to make this decision that you want to run for Congress.
Yeah, you know, we've had these conversations in the past, and we've talked about any opportunity to expand, elevate, highlight, promote the great work that we're doing in Baltimore County, the transformative change that we're leading. To take that to another level is something that we always said we would explore, and now we're doing. I think this is a moment where we can go and show D.C. how to get things done. I'm excited about the prospect of being in part of a new generation of leadership in our nation's capital. And, you know, I'm going because I started my career as a public school teacher, and I taught my students how fragile and important our democracy is. So I'm going to go to Washington to make sure that our democratic systems are in place. I'm going to go to make sure that we are addressing the kitchen table issues that our residents are facing to create jobs and opportunity. And, you know, you guys know me. I believe in being a leader who works together to find compromise without compromising our values. That's what I've done as Baltimore County Executive, and that's what people can expect from me as a congressman.
Johnny Olszewski, Baltimore County Executive, and now you just heard it, announced candidate for the second congressional district seat as a Democrat. And County Executive, you know, there are a lot of issues right now going on in Washington, whether it's illegal immigration, whether it's the conflicts in the Middle East, and a lot of things going on. What do you think are your major, what are you going to be telling voters you're going to focus on primarily when you get to Washington?
Yeah, I appreciate that, C4. I mean, for me, it really is about bread and butter. We are concerned about making sure that men and women have jobs and opportunity, that we're, you know, sensitive to things like inflation, that we're creating those pipelines to opportunity. The nursing program, for example, that we're doing in partnership with St. Joe and CCBC in Baltimore County is a great example of that. I'm a big believer that we need to continue our work to combat the issues of climate change and think about a clean energy economy and resiliency. Again, things that we're doing here in Baltimore County. Again, I mentioned at the top, really, I think just the basic institutions of supporting people like our election workers. As county executive, I have responsibility for oversight of our elections. And I can tell you firsthand that our election officials are pros. They are professional, responsible, and that our elections are secure. They are safe. And want to make sure that is a message that we're taking to D.C. And again, just showing, I think more than anything, showing that we can tackle these hard issues. We can have hard conversations. We don't have to compromise our values, but we can find compromise. And so in Baltimore County, whether it was gun safety through our SAFE Act, that was a bipartisan piece of legislation. We've done police reform, bipartisan. We, you know, had the FOP at the table. We've had Republican and Democratic legislators at the table. Tackling a structural budget deficit, we've pretty much done it all. And really just, you know, in general, I'd say Congressman Ruppersberger leaves an incredible legacy of doing those kinds of things, providing incredible constituent services and delivering capital and dollars to the district. That's exactly the kind of legacy I want to build on.
We do know how these things go, though. In a lot of ways in Washington, they're partisan votes on a regular basis. It's a party line vote. All Republicans, all Democrats go that way. And you say that you want to have an open mind when you do these things. But, you know, there are party politics at play, a lot of pressures that happen as well. I'm not going to sit here and ask you, you know, are you definitely going to vote for everything that the Democrats want? But what can you say? How can you show us that you would be an independent thinker in Washington? Or do you not want to be an independent thinker?
Yeah, fair question, Bryan. And that's something we should be asking of all of our individuals running for any office. But I think the best indicator of future performance is past performance. And so if you look at, again, the work that we've done, almost every single piece of legislation, all of our budgets have been bipartisan, unanimous, because we bring people together. Tonight, we continue that work locally in Baltimore County. We have our town hall series. We bring government close to the people. And I think that that's just sort of the spirit of governing we need at all levels of government. We need people who are willing to bring people in, invite them to the conversation, to be open, accountable, and transparent about the work that they do. And I think that having a generation, a new generation of leaders who are willing to go to Washington and demand that we find those paths forward, knowing the structures of where we currently are with the party splits and divided government, the only way that Americans and the people in Maryland are going to see progress is that we have people who are willing to come to the table and try to find paths forward on the things that we can agree to. I'm really proud of my legacy of forging those kinds of compromises and consensuses here in Baltimore County. I've done that as a proud Democrat, you know, not compromising my values, but also recognizing that sometimes we have to give and take a little bit to actually make progress. And that's the kind of, you know, congressperson that I aspire to be. And if I'm lucky enough, that's what people can count on me to do in Washington.
I was going to say, running for Congress in the 2nd Congressional District, Jenny Olszewski's on board with us, Baltimore County Executive. You will have to, though, deal as a congressman with foreign policy issues. The president of the United States is supposed to be, we're supposed to hear today about what the response will be to the death and murder of three service members over in Jordan. How do you see yourself viewing foreign policy issues? Like what can we expect to see as you take on some of these foreign policy questions?
You know, you can expect me to be incredibly engaged. C4, you know, I've got a PhD, so I think that understanding things like our histories are incredibly important. And, you know, knowing that these conflicts and these challenges are all happening within context. And so, you know, to your point, I'm looking forward to seeing what the president has to say today about our response. We have to make sure that America is strong, that we have a strong national defense, but that we are also applying those diplomatic solutions and working with countries across the world to make sure that America is strong, that we're safe, that we're secure. And so as a member of Congress, I look forward to taking that holistic approach, both supporting our incredible armed services, but also ensuring that we're doing those other things so that America is the leader, both at home and abroad, that we always have been and that I think we should be into the future.
So if you were to win, what do you do? Commute every day to D.C.? That's a long time to listen to the C4 and Bryan Nehman show. You know,
that's right.
You got that going for it, I guess.
You know, I mean, those are conversations I'll have with my wife and my daughter, and I appreciate their support. And frankly, want to thank everyone for the overwhelming support that we've received since our launch yesterday. But I think that there's a very good chance that you'll see me on the MARC train. Okay. Coming to and from Washington many days. I don't know that'll be every day, but again, I think these are family decisions and in consultation with them, workloads, et cetera. But I think there's a good chance you'll see me commuting. And that, as you said, I can call in regularly. I'm happy to listen as we've done and stay focused on the important work happening both in Maryland, but also in D.C. with you guys.
Well, we brought you on to talk, of course, about your announcement yesterday for Congress. But I do have to ask you, because the council is dealing with this right now, County Council, about expanding its seats from 7 to maybe 9 or even 11. And the Baltimore papers have you at least voicing support for this. Are you supportive of the council increasing its size?
Absolutely, yeah. And as you said, C4, I've been very clear in terms of my position. Baltimore County has become much larger than we were decades and decades ago when charter government was first established. We are more diverse. We currently have a county council with all men, only one person of color on the council. So in addition to expanding the council, which I think we should do at least by 2 seats, I really would support seeing 4. But at least to some sort of expansion to create more opportunities for government to be closer to the people more than anything. And that's the biggest thing. I've learned in my job as county executive that being connected to people and listening to them makes for a more responsive and stronger government. And so I think having council members with smaller districts will allow for that. It also allows the council to reflect our diversity, to allow more opportunities for women and candidates of color to be successful. I think if you couple the council expansion with the public financing of elections that we've already passed, there's a real opportunity in 2026 to have, I think, a vibrant, diverse set of representatives who are close to the people. So I think council expansion is absolutely the right move. and encouraging my colleagues on the council to consider that strongly and make that happen.
Finally, County Executive Johnny O, just make your final appeal. Why should voters consider Johnny Olszewski for the 2nd Congressional District?
I'm honored to be the county executive here and to represent almost 85% of the current congressional district. I want to be a leader who will fight to ensure that Maryland is a leader on all of the things that we need about climate change, our green economy, focusing on those kitchen table issues, finding compromise without compromising our values, being responsive, doing big, important things together. For far too long, Congress has been gridlocked. Republicans and Democrats aren't coming together to get work done. You can be assured that I will be down there fighting for you each and every day, moving not just Maryland's 2nd Congressional, but our state and our country forward. I'd be honored to have your support.
Johnny Olszewski, once again, Democratic candidate for the 2nd Congressional District. And you got anything set up yet where folks can get to you, websites or anything yet?
Absolutely. You can hit gojohnnyo.com right now. Check out the new campaign. Connect with us. I'll be heading down to Annapolis later today, both to file for office, but also I've got a meeting with the Senate President, Speaker of the House, as the President of the Maryland Association of Counties, talking about things like education transparency and sharing the concerns of my colleagues across local government here in the state.
Well, you might need to give Bill Ferguson a hug because that Ravens game is still on him too, Johnny.
I think we all could use a hug after that Ravens game, but at least we've got some exciting news coming out of the Orioles.
There
and,
you go.
Really, you know, looking forward to pitchers and catchers reporting soon.
Yeah. Johnny, thank you so much.
Thank you. Good to have you on.
Guys, be well.
Baltimore County Executive Johnny Olszewski, candidate for Congress.